Well, hello. How many of you parents out there want to make sure that you don't raise your child to become a people pleaser? I mean, so many of us as adults know how much that has robbed us of our lives. How many times throughout our lives that we have had to be incongruent, unauthentic, and completely betray ourselves in order to attain the approval or please somebody else. And I want to raise everyone's awareness on one key thing that does this to children, and this probably happened in your childhood too. If you can stop this one thing that I'm about to share with you, you will completely lift the veil of guilt off your child's life so that they can live their life the way they want to and need to, not the way someone else expects of them, and have to forego who they are in order to meet that person's standards or be liked and approved of by that person. And here's what it comes down to. You know, we all use, and for generations this has been used, the whole other people have it worse. You know, the whole I want to teach my child about gratitude, and the way that I do that is by telling them that they should eat their dinner because there's kids in Africa that are starving, that they should be grateful for the toys they've got because there's some kids that don't even get a toy for Christmas, and all these kind of things. And all it does is this: it teaches the child to feel wrong for having their own desire. And I want to share with you a very personal story, and this is a vulnerable moment for me, but let me show you where this starts to build a programming in their life that shows up later on and really, I don't even know the word, it just takes your power from you and makes it so hard to move through your life the way that you are being called to. For me, this happened with my marriage separation and my divorce. You know, there was nothing wrong with our marriage. From an outsider's point of view, we literally had everything. We honored each other. We liked each other a lot. We barely ever fought. You know, he supported my goals and dreams. I supported his goals and dreams. We had our own time. We had this time together. We were aligned in some of our values. And I sat there just feeling like it still wasn't enough. I had been on a very deep awakening journey. And that awakening journey had led me, when I, you know, took the cold, hard layers off myself and really did the deep work on myself to take the armors off my heart, I discovered this depth to me that I never knew existed. And in that depth, I just wanted more. I wanted more connection. I wanted more true intimacy. I mean, like, into me see, and let me see into you. You know, I wanted a connection that can't even be articulated with words. It's only something the soul understands. And it took me a long time to give myself permission to be able to make the decision that was right for me, and ultimately, you know, what I believe to be the decision that belonged to the bigger plan, not Holly's plan. And here's why. Because I sat there in exactly this programming that we quite often put on our children, going like, how wrong, so many people out there would die to have my kind of marriage. And here I am, I've got the marriage that everyone wants, and it's not enough for me. How selfish am I? You know, how wrong is it for me to want more? Why can't this be enough? What's wrong with me that I want more even though I've got it really well? And what that did is it just riddled me with guilt and forced me to completely betray and dishonor what it was that I needed, that my marriage wasn't able to provide for me. He was on a very different journey to me, and I wanted to honor that, but it meant that we couldn't do life together unless one of us was willing to dishonor ourselves. And I, over time, I traced it back. Where does this all come from? And you know where it comes from? Being told as a child that you should be grateful because other people have more. That you should stop wanting more just because there are people that don't have it. At the end of the day, there are people on this planet that don't have certain things, but that is their journey. If you are on the spiritual and consciousness journey and you believe in multiple lives and all those things, we can't pick and choose when that theory suits us. And so we have to understand that those children who have those situations, I mean, they came into those lives for the purpose of their own spiritual expansion. And by the same token, our children chose us as their parents and came into our lives for their spiritual expansion. And personally, I think that the one thing that we don't have the right to shut down in any child is what it is they want, any of their desires. Now, I'm not saying not to teach them about gratitude, but the way to teach them about gratitude is by helping them understand the value of what they have without needing to draw a parallel or to use as a measuring stick of what other people don't have, because here's what it does. Ultimately, it creates shame in your child. Let me share with you how very quickly. What it does is the child goes, okay, so this is how I feel. I feel like I want more. I feel like I'm full. My body doesn't want to eat the rest of my dinner. But when I voice my own desire, somebody that I look up to tells me that I'm wrong. So if I'm wrong for feeling that, but that is how I feel, then there must be something wrong with me. And that starts the diminishing internal voice that robs us all of our own self-esteem, our own self-worth, turns us into people pleasers, and ultimately robs us completely of our happiness. If you have enjoyed this video, if you have got value from it, please don't hold this value to yourself. Share it with another family, share it, comment down below. I would love to hear what kind of value you got from this and what other topics you would love me to help you with and do videos on, so that I can help your family make really big differences just with small tiny shifts. I'm Holly Noonan from The Holly Effect. Thank you for watching. Please share.